Happy New Year's Eve, HPG customers and friends. Today's the last day of 2019. We'll see 2020 tomorrow. I will not be here. I'm taking the day off. As you know, I think I stated before, my wedding anniversary is today as well. So my wife and I are going to a nice dinner and out tonight. So probably be up late and sleeping in. So I've been trying to get a lot of stuff done today before I leave. Some of you might know, I added some World War I and a couple of World War II 3D printed items, and I'm going to show you some other things. But I did want to just say thank you for a great year at HPG. As you know, I came full-time after 31 years in drafting. So I started back in August and just been blowing and going since. I hope that you've noticed the difference, me being here. Of course, I did take over a lot of the checking on orders and shipping and things like that. So it's not like I've had total free time just to sit here and design stuff and everything else, but it definitely given me a lot more hands-on and time to do more things. And of course, now that I'm here doing things, I'm finding more things I want to do and tapping into that. So I've got a lot of plates spinning in the air, but it's good. I am going to get some, I have some help coming next month. I'm going to hire a guy, and he's going to be pulling orders and cleaning the warehouse and stocking and doing all the things, a lot of the things that I've been doing. I haven't been pulling the orders. I actually have someone else that does that for four of the days of the week. But this is going to be a big help to me, and so I'm hoping to do more next year, given more time to design markers, more time to design, help design games, work with my designers, you know, looking at artwork, uploading 3D printed items, website stuff. I mean, just, I've got a lot of website cleaning up to do, and that's one of my goals in 2020 is to get in there and clean all that up. But I'm adding more and more stuff. As you notice, we added more 172nd infantry boxes over this last year. We added more 3D printed items. We've added more regular plastic items. I did get confirmation today from China that my gold color Japanese America pieces will ship today. So I should get those in a week, go through some QC. And then once we get those, we can make the sets and actually get them with the America game and start getting those out. I know a lot of people have them on their waiting list. So, you know, we'll have black Germans and we'll have black colored Germans. What do I have? The tan allies and the yellow gold Japanese forces. So those will be coming. Give us about a month, 6 weeks, and you should see those coming out. Other than that, the year's been great. Appreciate everyone, the orders, the attaboys. I get a lot of attaboys, and I do appreciate it. Of course, I do what I love. I really enjoy this. I've been playing Axis and Allies. Actually, I didn't start to about 88, but I've been blowing and going ever since then. Customizing, what if you could do this, do that. Always been a big history buff, been a big Risk player. You know, any historical game. Always played historical, never played fantasy. Nothing against it. It just wasn't my thing. But I'm a big science fiction fan. Always was when I was a kid, so I think that's why you start seeing some of these expansions. I have a little bit of sci-fi stuff in there or alternate history. It always has intrigued me, and I just love it, and I think it helps. We've had a lot of great, a lot of good feedback on our 36, how, you know, you can start, and with, you know, it's not always a scripted game. It's, you know, we've got a lot of good things coming, and they're going to be coming quicker, and we appreciate everyone's patience, and the designers really appreciate the games that they've helped design and put out for HPG, and they appreciate all the attaboys as well. So just wanted to say thank you, and I'll probably put another video out next week. It won't be at the end of this week, trying to get everything cleaned up. Like I said, I got to go to Vegas on the 11th with my wife. She's got a trade show out there and awards banquet and stuff. So we spent about 5 days out there. Supposed to go to the Grand Canyon on one day, the day before her award stuff starts. But I want to try to go maybe to Proving Ground or Area 51. I haven't told her that yet, but I don't think she watches these videos, so I might be okay. Wanted to show you something real quick before I get off topic here. I've been working on 3D printed stuff, and I wanted to tell you about scaling. Some people, I see 3D printed items, and people are asking me, what scale is he ships in? They're all over the place. You know, you can say approximate, you know, I know some people use different pieces for their tanks, you know, some metal pieces, 1/285, 1/300, and that's going to get you close. But some of the bigger stuff gets quite big. Now, the ships, you know, 1/2400 scale, way too big. You just have to scale it. Now, you can get some of the old pre-dreadnought stuff, possibly within scale, some of the smaller destroyers in scale. But, you know, HPG's been really working hard to try to get you some stuff. And my email, my personal email, not to HBG, is, well, to HBG, is Doug@historicalboardgaming.com. And send me an email and say, hey, I'd like to see these 3D pieces. I, you know, if I, and I'm going to put it in a folder and write them down. And if I start seeing a trend where more and more people want certain ones, we're going to produce them. I've got a lot of models we're trying to get out. So just let you know that they are coming. I want to show you this. Whoa, almost dropped it. As you can see, the scaling, put this over here. So that's out of the box. And I should put that here. That's our Mark IV. Ours is a little bigger, okay? But the reason is for scaling. This is a Mark IV. It's a skeleton tank, which was a U.S. prototype. That's the Flying Elephant, the heavy armor for U.K. That's the Mark IX Pig. That was an armor personnel carrier. That's the Charles II C. You see that one. It was after World War I, before World War II, French heavy tank. This is a Mark VIII Liberty tank designed by the U.S. and allies. Came out again at the end of the war. K-Wagon, big German heavy, super heavy tank. Then on this side, you got the, I want to say Shaman French. We have that out. A7V, of course, that's the German tank. That's the Heidi. That's also an armored personnel carrier. German, of course. And I'm not even trying to pronounce that, but that's the Austria-Hungary prototype tank. The motor something, and the FT-17 French light tank, which was used everywhere. But as you can see, I've got a scaling. There is a scaling to that. So they're not perfectly in scale. If the K-Wagon would be quite a bit larger, and it just gets too big for the board. So what I did is I do this with my bombers and everything. I pick out the largest carrier, like the, which is the Nimitz, or actually the larger one would be the Enterprise or the Ford. I say that's the top largest one I want on my board. And then I scale down from there. So this is the, you know, longest thing. Now there is going to be another, I'm getting a Mark I done, and also a Tadpole tank, which is going to be similar to the Liberty, but it's going to be, I believe, a little longer. So somewhere in there. So anyway, those are scaled out, just like the B-36 Peacemaker, which is a huge bomber, or B-52. If I scaled everything and say, okay, I'm going to use the B-17 as the scale and scale everything from there, B-52 would be huge, you know, or B-36. So I think it works for Axis and Allies. And those over here, I'm working on, if anyone's into the A-series rockets, we have an expansion. You have the A-12, A-11, the A-10, I believe, A-9, 6, and that's the 4B, I believe. So I'm trying to work those out. And the reason I'm working those out is because in our 85 and our 65 global game, we also have rockets, you know, the Vostok. We've got Space Shuttle, we've got the Apollo, and we're going to use that. There's going to be a space exploration in there. So I'm trying to make sure that these work out. Right now, these fins are too thick. They're not inconsistent with these other ones, so I'm working on those. And then we did put a few things out. Italian Sparvero, it was a converted passenger liner carrier. Wasn't completed. But I just put that on the website today. We got the M3 Lee Grant. That just put out today. I put the Leopard, German Leopard, Cold War, early mid-60s tank. And then you got the P26/40 Italian heavy tank, which is kind of a medium. And that's out. And then, of course, that's the German amphibious thing. I have not got that out on the website yet. I was making sure that I've got some correct scaling. Yeah, there's a Tiger II that we already have out. So anyway, I want to just say, I'm going to put this back. I can never get this thing back to the way it was. So anyway, I hope everyone has a happy new year. Keep following us on Facebook. Please chime in on all the global war pages. If you're interested in a certain era, get in there and get some information. We're still, you know, designing the 65 game, the 1985 game. 2025 Meltdown will be coming out after the pre-orders. Today is the last day of the pre-orders for the R36 V3. And I'm going to hopefully show you in, within a week the map and some other things. We're still working on, get some free 3D printed items for that pre-order. Chime in on what you think you'd like to see as freebies. I'm open. If not, I'm just going to pick something that I think that people might want. And other than that, not a lot. Of course, today is the last day also for the last week of the Christmas prize. Like I said, the first week was someone in the U.S., second week was someone in Canada, third week was someone in Italy that won a $100 gift certificate for HBG. So this is the last week. Any order through today will get, you know, the 22nd through the 31st, I should say. So we do hope everyone's safe tonight. Be careful. There are people that drink too much and are out late, so please be careful on your way home from wherever you are going. And again, I do appreciate everything. Tell my wife, happy anniversary. Thank you for supporting me in my endeavor here. And people, you need to know that I would never be able to do this without someone like my wife. She just very supportive. She understands. She knows I love doing this. You know, as long as I make a little money to bring home, she's good with it. But she is very supportive, and she listens to me when I talk about things and I'm wanting to do things and all that stuff. Of course, I will tell you, when I first started and I wanted, 10 years ago, I wanted to start this, she was like, who's going to buy this stuff? I mean, kind of like, are you serious? But she was kind of surprised that it's taken off. But I just wanted to reach out. Happy anniversary. I love you. Thank you for your support. My wife's name is Christy. So thank you, hon. And again, Happy New Year. It starts tomorrow, 2020. We'll see you on the backside. Take care. Bye.